out of gas, almost out of medicine.
So I'm out of that.
And her only food, what her friends feed her. Stage 4 cancer patient Yasmin Snyder doesn't have a penny to her name after her Social Security payment of $618 vanished from her Direct Express MasterCard, withdrawn from an ATM in Florida.
Florida? I don't know anybody in Florida. I've never been to Florida.
Comerica Bank, which has the exclusive contract to run the government's prepaid debit card, told her it could take up to 90 days to investigate.
I don't know what to do next. I don't know how long this is going to take and whether I'm going to have a place to go.
I've called about 300 times.
Navy veteran Robert Grimes says he's fought Comerica for more than a year, over $109 fraudulently taken from his Direct Express card.
I just want them to give me my money back. That's it and that's all.
There's no risk of lost or stolen benefits checks.
This commercial for the Direct Express MasterCard calls it a safe, easy, and convenient way to get your federal benefits.
They're a bunch of damn liars.
Twice a victim to fraud on his own Direct Express card, author and private investigator J.B. Sims says fraud victims across the country are battling Comerica to get their money back.
They have no other means of income. You got a cancer patient, you got military veterans with PTSD. They've already fought. They're tired of fighting.
Federal banking rules protect you from debit card fraud. Once you report it, the bank has 10 days to investigate. If they need longer and you've submitted the paperwork requested, you're supposed to get a provisional credit. But some can't wait that long. One person in Rhode Island left without their money complained, being evicted out of my residence. Another in Washington State said, I will lose my house and car. We wanted to know the scope of Direct Express fraud and how long people are going without their money.
Who's keeping an eye on this program?
Good question.
Ping pong between federal agencies, the Treasury Department told us to ask Comerica directly, which told us specific fraud data is not released to the public, but its fraud rate for the Direct Express program is among the lowest in the industry.
I think there's a fox in the hen house.
Sims thinks the fraud may be tied to the fact Comerica uses an outside company to handle Direct Express calls.
And I think the FBI needs to get involved because there's going to be some heads rolling.
Should our government work for the people? That's why we're here.
Senator Elizabeth Warren, who's considering a run for president, fired off this lengthy letter to the head of Comerica Bank last month, concerned about the lack of transparency, saying interruption in accessing these basic living expenses could have devastating consequences for those receiving federal benefits. Comerica admitted to us its processes are not perfect, but says Direct Express is a secure program with strong fraud protections, adding for the past 9 years, the program has had a 94% cardholder satisfaction score on an independent survey. But both Robert and Yasmin were not satisfied until we got involved and they got their money back.
I can pay my rent and I can get my medication.
But Sims warns others using these prepaid cards.
It's Russian roulette. It's Russian roulette for the people that have a Direct Express card because eventually it's going to happen to you. You are going to have to fight to get your money back.